In this lecture, we are discussing about the automation and the PLC, which is the part of the subject PLCM, that is Programmable Logical Controller and Microcontroller. In this topic, first we start with automation. And first of all, what is automation? Automation, the art of self-operation is called automation, which do not need any human activities. The work without human activities is known as industrial automation. And automation is the combination of electrical, mechanical, electronics, instrumentation, and computer engineering concepts. For example, this cat is sitting on the board. When this cat is sitting on the board, the milk is dropped into the plate. If the cat removes from the board, this milk stopped, dropped in the plate. This all operation done with the help of automations. The industrial automation parts. The industrial automation includes PLC. That is a programmable logical controller, HMI, human machine interface, drives, SCADA. SCADA is the supervisory control acquisition and supervisory control and data acquisition system. These all are the automations part. And next is the type of automation. For example, first is industrial automation, second is building automation, and third is home automation. In industrial automation, we can take the example of assembly, car assembly lines. In today life, all the work is done with the help of robotics in car factory, in car assembly lines. So that's the part of the industrial automation. In building automation and in home automation, for example, in today's life, there is automatic sensor switches to close the door and open the door. That is the part of automation. Industry segment in which automation needed. The automation mainly needed in food and beverages industries, petrochemical industries, semiconductor industries, pharmaceutical industries, and oil production industries, and freshwater industries. In every industry, the whole work is done with the help of automations. After that, PLC. Before going through PLC, we also know about the history of PLC. The PLC was first invented in 1960. The first commercial and successful PLC was developed and designed by Dick Modley for Modicon. This Modicon is the company, and the author name is Dick Modley. He was introduced PLC in 1960. Earlier, nowadays, it was a machine with thousands of electronic parts. This is the picture of the PLC in practical life. This is the PLC. The PLC looks like that. Next is PLC. Definition of PLC. Now, what is PLC? PLC is nothing but a programmable logical controller. A PLC is the digital computer used for automation of electrochemical processes, such as control of machinery on factory assembly lines, amusement rides, or lighting fixture. A PLC is used in many industries and machines. And this is the and the next one is the controller cycle of PLC. In controller cycle of PLC, PLC mainly consists of three parts, that is input, evaluation, and the output. In input, we use sensors, automatic switches, push buttons. This is a push button. At the input, we use that push button sensors. And in evaluation system, in output, there may be any peripheral, for example, motors or the factory assembly lines. And this evaluation system is the evaluation system is the communication link between the input and the output. All the communication wires is joined with the help of that switches. This is the block diagram of PLC. Here, input module, processors, output modules, power supply, programming device, and from sensors we use only push buttons, contacts, limit switches, and in the output we can use motors, solenoids, contactors, alarms, etc. And the main function of the power supply is provides the voltage needed to run the primary PLC components. the main use of power supply is to provide the voltage needed to the PLC components. And next is input output modules. The function of the input output modules provides the signal conversion and isolation between the internal logic level signals inside the PLC and the field high level signals. And the main function of the input output module is to convert conversion signals and execute them and give at the output. And processor the main function of the processor is to provide intelligence to command and governs the activities of the entire PLC system. It is just as a CPU of the PLC, a central processing unit. And the programming device, the use of the programming device is used to enter the desired program that will determine the sequence of operation and control of process equipment or driving machine. All the programs for any particular application is run on run through that programming device. And next and next is advantages of PLC. And there are huge advantages of PLC. First one is flexibility. There is a flexibility to flexible flexibility to work with PLC. Easy programming. The programming we entered in the PLC is easy to design. High speed of operation, security, better communication, reliability and maintainability. Environmental consideration, there is no harmful for the environment due to, if we use PLC. Next is PLC programming. Before going to PLC programming, the PLC is there are three main programming for PLC. First is ladder logic programming, and second is functional block diagrams, and third is statement list. In ladder logic programming, we use logical graphic symbols similar to a schematic circuit diagrams. For example, in logical symbol, we use NOR gate, NAND gate, etc. And in functional block diagrams, is represented as a box with function name written in. In this, we use boxes with the function name written in with their function name. And in statement list, it is the programming language using mnemonic abbreviations of Boolean logical operations. And Boolean operations work on the combination of variables that are true or false. This Boolean operation that is used in the digital electronics. And the software used for this PLC programming is Zilio software. And all the programs is run on the Zilio software. Thank you.